Midnight Drive, journey where players thrive. I'm your tour guide, Jay Brooks. We modulate, never pump fake. In Ohio's capital, that being the 614, otherwise known as Columbus. Columbus is home to the Ohio State Buckeyes, righteous creatives, divine individuals, but most importantly, poets. And as you need to know it, we got the one and only, guys, Kalypso, as y'all know, but also know her as Bria Clark. How you doing, Queen?
Hey, how are you?
Hey, it's an honor to have you here today.
I'm here.
Hey, as per usual, you know what I'm saying? Tell the people where we at.
So we are in Columbus, Ohio. I was born and raised here. I grew up on the north side, like the woodland area. I've been here my whole life, been through a lot. I can relate to a lot of different types of people. So, you know, that's me.
I think we got ourselves a legendary episode. You know, this is not only for the person with the pen and the pad that's writing poetry. This one for the streets. It's for somebody who ever been through something. For people who just need healing in general, you know? So, you know, to segue back into your origin, that being your childhood, I noticed you said you lived in the woodland area on the north side. So, growing up on the north side, like, what were certain things that you got into as a kid? First childhood fight, you know, first time riding a bike. Like, give us a day in the life of Bria Clark, okay. Early 90s.
So, my life changed a lot on a consistent basis. First, I have a younger sister. We grew up with our parents. There was some things like drug abuse, mental illness, domestic violence that tore our family apart. So, our grandparents stepped in and, you know, so I feel like that's a lot of people's background story. They were raised by aunties, grandmas. It takes a village to raise children. So when I was younger, I kind of always felt like I was in this box and I wanted to burst out. I had a lot of things that I wanted to express. I grew up in an environment where nobody ever asked, are you okay? Or is there anything wrong? Or you want to talk about this, that, and the third?
Right.
I wanted to do so many different things, but I didn't have the resources, or, you know, people just weren't invested into me in the way that I needed to be invested in it. So now I'm an adult and I'm trying to just do all these creative things that I've always been passionate about, and a lot of it has to do with expression and expressing all the things that I've been through. So I feel like I've always been a very social person. I've always been a social butterfly. I never really got into much trouble, unless I did get in some situations for running my mouth.
Running her mouth, man. Probably definitely her family's house. Y'all know how that turned out.
So I never really had a lot of issues or got into trouble a lot. I wasn't one of those kids. I had all different types of friends. I had friends who were fighting, friends who were, you know, doing things that they weren't supposed to be doing. Jumped off the porch super early, and then I had friends like me. I had all types of friends. So
that's what it was like growing up on the north side, right?
Yeah. And I was kind of sheltered by my grandparents. They were just scared of the world, and I mean that kind of happens when, you know, your kids, you know, they kind of get into different stuff, and you kind of see what they experience and the choices they make. So they were like, I barely got to go over friends' houses outside of just playing outside, like on our street.
So question though, like, you know, going through all that, you know, living with your grandparents, quote unquote, being sheltered in a sense, like, how did that, you know, help you adapt to the real world? Because I know sometimes it can be a culture shock when, you know, you're young and, you know, you can't do these things, and then you go to the public school, seeing all, you know.
Yes, everybody got to go to, like, teen night and meet at the movies and go to the skating rink. I, like, never got to do stuff like that, barely. See, my younger sister, she was a little bit more rebellious, so she got into a lot more, you know, situations, and, you know, she was, she encountered a lot of different circumstances than I did. I'm the type of person, I see what's going on around me, and I'm like, yeah, I don't want that. Yeah, okay, that's not too bad. I'll dabble in that, but, you know,
right.
I've always had, like, a mind of my own.
So, leader with a cause, you know what I'm saying? Not even just a leader, an innovator, though. More than a creator. So, you know, we have all these things. We have, you know, Bria basically experiencing the world from this sheltered environment, going to these schools. What was your first passion ever in life that you wanted to pursue? And how does it apply to you today?
growing up, my grandma always used to call me and my sister sister, and she would tell me we could be the next black, we could be the Black Shirley Temple, and she'd be like, you look like you could be related to Halle Berry. Like, she always made me feel like I was meant to be a superstar. So honestly, that kind of was the first thing that I would see when I closed my eyes and I dreamt about my future. And then as I got older, I started writing to like release my emotions, and poetry, songs, even raps and stuff like that. I would write freestyles all the time, but I never shared them with anybody. What else? I did start doing art. Well, we had art class in school, so art and dance also inspired me, and I'm very passionate about that as well. I even, when I was in elementary school, I had a piece put into the art museum here. So I don't know why nobody ever like tried to encourage me to do more art and like grow my skills, but now I'm like, hey, what's up? Like, we can do whatever. We grown now. So right. I'm trying to invest in all of that.
That is live, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's good when you're growing up to experience different, you know, activities, different walks of life, different experiments, because I mean, ultimately it helps create the person that we have front of us today. So with all that being said and done, at what point when it was like, yo, I really want to pursue poetry, I really want to light up the world with my words, and I want to possess this vernacular that captivates the soul, when did that all transpire?
The craziest thing, I didn't even think about, like, think bigger about the things that I was interested in until I got older. So when I was younger, it was just all about like expressing myself, and I used to smoke, and I would literally lay on my back and just let my thoughts just pour out of my ears, like, and then I'd just gather it all up and put it on paper. And I believe after I had my child as an adult 2 years ago, I was like, you know what, how come we haven't done everything we wanted to do? Like, that was one of my biggest things about becoming a mother that I wanted to change. I always wanted to be the type of mom that did whatever she wanted to do in life and accomplished everything that I want to accomplish. So I want my sons, my daughters to get older and be like, well, my mom wanted to do this and she did it, so I can do it too. And then also, when you walk in your purpose, you inspire others to do the same. I don't want to just exist. I want to live my life, you know, by choice, intentionally. So. And also trigger that in others as well.
Yes, indeed, yes, indeed. Y'all heard it first. The goddess Kalypso, as y'all need to know. Per usual, it's getting about that time. And seems to me it's a smoke break. So, we're gonna get up with y'all. This is Midnight Drive.
Yeah, look. I got lots of pressure on my mind, but I'm a diamond in the rough, and it's only matter of time. Shit they doing in real life, always conflicting with their rhymes, and I've been used to getting dimes, but now I do this for my mom. Look, niggas be running their mouth. I'm busy running the route to reaching my dreams. It's me and my team, don't give a fuck what they be talking about. They watching me play, I'm bringing the scouts. Could do this all day, I ain't micing about. I'm peeping your bitch, what I'm liking about it. It's all in my face, one night in the mouth. You niggas a phase, but you in your place. Mug you in your face, shit ain't a race. And shit if it was, you know who in first place. Not giving them grace, ain't showing no love. Y'all brought me to this place, took out the gloves. I done broke all the rules, I ain't come here to play, bitch. What's the word right now? Shit, cooling like a fan.
Drive, the journey where players thrive. I'm your tour guide, Jay Brooks. We in the 614, comfortably at your door, the lovely Miss Bria Clark. Welcome back, beloved. How you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great.
So, you know, we touched on briefly upbringing, things of that nature. Let's talk about academics, because everybody likes to know people academically, at least. High school, where did you attend, and what was that like?
I am a Nubian. I went to Afrocentric Early College.
Hello.
I did drill team. I tried track, but that didn't work out. I was in a rap group called Desire with Jasmine Brooks. She's in Atlanta now, so
hold up
shout
now.
Out to her.
We have a rapper in here. Don't leave that part out. Hello.
Yeah, so I always wrote, and we made two tracks together, and I mean, we really didn't work on anything much outside of that, but it was a wonderful, that was my first music experience. So it was very fun, and we just was experimenting with ourselves. And then I went to Columbus downtown for junior and senior year and obtained my cosmetology license. After that, went to Wilberforce University. Shout out to the Woo.
Yeah,
I was a Bulldog.
Right around the corner from what? Dayton, Ohio.
Yeah, it's right across the street from Central State. So that was a wonderful experience. My college experience was kind of wild. I hung out with the guys, you know, like little sis type stuff. Not on that other stuff. But I was at a phase in life where it was the first time not being close to my family. Even though they were an hour away, they weren't like across town, or, you know, I wasn't living at home. So I believe that I was a little bit angry too, because I was growing into myself and I had realized that I had a voice and I hadn't been using it. So like, I didn't take no shit from nobody. I got into some altercations, and yeah, that was that. I started customizing clothes and selling snacks. So that's where I started the serial entrepreneur journey, and also coming into fashion. So I transferred to Bethune-Cookman in Daytona Beach, Florida. I was only there for a semester. It was a wonderful experience. But of course, leaving Ohio and going to Florida, I don't want to say I wasn't ready for that type of transition. I was more so even more uncomfortable than I was. And then, to be completely honest, I never really liked school. I love to learn. I'm a social butterfly. I love people. I love connecting. I love everything, especially about going to a HBCU, the step and all that. But I really wish that I had the knowledge and the information that I had now, because I didn't need to go to college to be a serial entrepreneur.
Right. You know, a lot of people, they believe that. You know, their parents tell them, hey, go to college, enroll, attend,
right,
you know, put up these 4 years and get this degree. And in all actuality, you know, you have these resources on your internet, at your local library. You know, one of the homies might have a book or two. So, again, make a conscious, righteous decision. Whatever you do, teach yourself. Don't cheat yourself.
Yeah.
Straight up.
Yes, indeed. So, you know, going to these HBCUs, what was your probably most memorable experience, and maybe most entertaining experience?
Ooh, the culture of it. It was, there was nothing like being surrounded by people who come from the same backgrounds as you. Even though we all walk in our own story, you know, we all are still cut from the same fabric. So it had to be like seeing the sororities and fraternities, all the different types of ways of together, that there can be togetherness and unity, and, you know, people being surrounded by people who want to see you succeed, not so much of more negative things like how it was back home. So, yes, it was an eye-opener.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times, you know, up in the areas, you know, you have people from Ohio, mm-hmm. Detroit, Chicago, Midwest, and they're heavy.
Yes,
and, you know, to be around all those cultures at once, and everybody's just kumbaya, and, you know what I'm saying, building these business connections is lovely.
Yes.
So, by all means, networks, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
You know, so, from that point, you know, let's jump into the whole entrepreneur aspect of you, right? Because that's what people are going to know you as.
Yes.
The goddess Kalypso, what does that business stand for? What inspired it? And how long have you guys been in business?
Okay, so I started it in 2019. After I got through my postpartum depression after having my daughter, I had to kind of like pull myself up and like, okay, like we gotta get out of this. Since it was my first child, I wasn't really knowledgeable about postpartum depression and how it's normal, natural, you know, it's just an imbalance in your hormones after, you know, your body had to grow so many different parts, more part, add on more to you to nurture the growth of a child. Right. So, you know, your body goes into shock after that, and I was like a mess. But that mess, like, gave birth to something beautiful. And after that, I started doing these CBD bath bomb baskets, and I was selling sage and just all things that help relax people, because that's what I needed. I needed some peace of mind. Right. So that's why I started the Goddess Kalypso biz. I'm very big on meditation, lifting your vibration, shadow work, you know, all things healing. And healing never stops. And that's like, that, I think that's my main staple that I promote with my business. Otherwise, I'm just like shoving positivity down people's throats, because we cater too much to the negative feelings. And sometimes we can succumb to those. And I don't want people to, like, I want people to know that, hey, we're all experiencing, you know, life. And we just gotta keep on going and let it shift us and mold us into being bigger and better.
Yes, indeed. Yeah. That's lovely.
Thank you.
Again, you know, Bria Clark, the one and only. Nonetheless, man, we about to pop into a smoke break. Now watch the Midnight Drive.
Had to learn how to swim when I caught a wave. Put that on my life, I'ma find a way. Gotta carry my pole any time of day. I get on my knees every night and pray. I pray that my real niggas see the light. I pray that they call if they need advice. Pray that they make it home when they read their rights. Money, power, respect, what I need in life. Think I'm infatuated with popping tags. Like that boy Sherman, I got it bad. I elevated, now these niggas mad. I jumped out a plane and landed on a bag. Think the man above it, I'm still alive. 24-7, I'm on the ground. They looking for me, I've been getting mad. B.I.G. to the money, I'm hypnotized. Blowing money with the fam, that's G shit. Breaking bread with the team, that's G shit. Without my niggas, man, I probably wouldn't be shit. Without my lady, man, I probably wouldn't be shit. They wanna block my shine, that's an eclipse. They couldn't stop my grind, no defense. I lay it all on the line, that's a free throw. Big dog, MJ, 23 shit. Your bitch jumped on the wave, now she seasick. Freak bitch, good brain, made a dean's list. Rap niggas wanna talk down on me. You in the way, little nigga, stop reaching. All of my life, I've been wishing on a star, diamonds and chains and foreign cars. I know some niggas dancing on the walk, you think they graduated from Juilliard. Ride around getting it, titty boy, 2 chains. 10 toes down when I step in these food games. I pull up black on black like Bruce Wayne. I lay a fuck nigga down for the loose chain.
They say I'm out of character, but I know the more the merrier. You play with me, I embarrass ya. I keep putting off on my area, I got the world in hysteria. For the love of the money I grab, for the love of my niggas I murk,
I murk.
For the love of the puss I stunt,
I stunt.
For the love of my sons I bust.
I tell a bitch from the jump I ain't looking for love, and that pussy ain't shit without trust.
And God we clutch, sometimes I just pop out and flex. I do that just to knock off the rust.
Had to learn how to swim when I caught a wave. Put that on my life, I'ma find a way. Gotta carry my pole any time of day. I get on my knees every night and pray. I pray that my real niggas see the light. I pray that they call if they need advice. Pray that they make it home when they read their rights. Money, power, respect, what I need in life. Think I'm infatuated with popping tags. Like that boy Sherman, I got it bad. I elevated, now these niggas mad. I jumped out a plane and landed on a bag. Think the man above it, I'm still alive. 24-7, I'm on the ground. They looking for me, I've been getting mad. B.I.G. to the money, I'm hypnotized.
Lil' old me got on big mad. How I leave and come back with a bag. Fast forward, got a passport, and if I want it now, I pay cash. Sure, when I leave, them whores talk trash. I settle the beef with the pen in the pad. If I put the paws on the hoe, I be scaring myself, cause it always in bad. That nigga red, no riding. Ask yourself, is a shit worth dying? Time on the shelf, but my nigga still sliding. They throw shade, but a bitch still shining. Respect on my name, cause a bitch been grinding. I showed up like perfect timing. And SGB, my brother. Bow him, I put a bitch in a gutter. And that's on mother.
Oh, God.
Pray for the ones who was made examples. Pray for the families left dismantled. Light shit up, no Roman candles. Came a long way, no soul on my sandals. Money, power, respect, it's a gamble. God only gon' give you what you can handle. Or so they say, so I pray. Send one up like every day. Double M on my back, double M on my mind. They know I'm gon' grind. Vibrating all on high. Came through like, what do I sign? They hate this all time. time. Chakras are aligned. I asked for a sign and they sent Benjamin. And we making moves, so I gotta make new friends.
Had to learn how to swim when I caught a wind. Put that on my life, I'ma find a way. Gotta carry my pole any time of day. I get on my knees every night and pray. I pray that my real niggas see the light. I pray that they call if they need advice. Pray that they make it home when they read their rights. Money, power, respect, what I need in life. Think I'm infatuated with popping tags. Like the boy Sharaman, I got it bad. I elevated, now these niggas mad. I jumped out a plane and landed on a bag. Think the man above and I'm still alive. 24-7, I'm on the ground. They looking for me, I've been getting mad. B.I.G. to the money, I'm hypnotized.
Pleasant out, Pluto.
Honestly, I am trying to spread my wings when it comes to networking, because I'm one of those people, like, if I had a studio, I would lock myself in a studio for days and just get everything that's inside of me out in different art forms. I can't think of anybody just yet off the top of my head, but I do want to eventually throw an event, you know, and I want to start doing open mic nights and stuff like that, where it's not just for people who perform poetry and spoken word, but like music and, you know, somebody can do live painting, like all everybody's different. Like, I want it to be a collective, so a collective display of emotion and art.
Captivated and honestly, you guys should be too. Stay tuned for all the dope creation she has in the works. Let's also tap into this. I mean, the world wants to know this. Us here at Midnight Drive, we love music.
Yes.
We love musicians. We love supporters. We love classic MCs. So, we get to talk about your top five, dead or alive. Let's dive into R&B. What's your top five, dead or alive?
R&B that are alive? Whew. Okay, Erykah Badu for sure. Even though, like, I wouldn't even put that genre on her. But yeah. Let's see, who else?
Peasant out Pluto.
Jhené Aiko. Trying to throw a guy in there too, but the women are kind of dominating
right now. Women doing their thing right now.
Man, with, like, in every freaking.
All time.
Ooh, I'm more of a hip hop and rap head.
Really?
Yes. I listen to like old, like New Edition, Tony.
Okay.
Not so much.
Pretty Brown Eyes,
no? No, it's so cliche. So cliche to me. Okay, so I said two. Three more R&B. I mean, nobody in Tony, so I'm saying them. Right,
so does that complete your group? Like, that's your top three? Three out of your five right there, Tony.
Yeah, let's just leave it there because I like too much music.
Okay, so seeing as, you know, we're dealing with a hip-hop historian, in other words. Someone who challenged me in every aspect of hip-hop.
Oh, Lord.
Let's talk about your top five, dead or alive, in hip-hop.
Okay, so we're going to go all across the border with this one. First thing, first group, Outkast. I love them. They inspire me in so many different ways, and it's just, woo. Outkast, right now I've been tapping into Rio from Flint, Michigan. Let's see who else. I love Mezzo too. Welcome home, Peasy. Let's see who else. Nas, and one more person. Lord. Drake. Yes.
One time for Aubrey Graham. I'll be damned. And that's dope, though. But listen, we're going to take one last smoke break. Roll up, hold up, and stroll up. This is the Midnight Drive.
With flounder and search for treasures in the sands. Down here I ran into Sade and Janae. Down here the water blue just like Kool-Aid.
One,
That was Nautical Nonsense from Kaleidoscope Fantasies by the one and only Bria Clark. See, that Sade bar, that hit me in my heart, but I ain't gonna get all poetic on y'all. I'm gonna connect y'all. So Bria, how can they tap in, get connected?
Okay, so I do have a couple different social media platforms. On Instagram, you can follow me at the goddess Kalypso. Kalypso is spelled with a K. The goddess Kalypso Biz is on Facebook as well, so tune in, get all this dope energy, and then you can also shop for my products on www.thegoddesskalypso.com, and you can get my book on Amazon or at Barnes & Noble. Kaleidoscope Fantasies by Bria Clark, y'all.
Yes, indeed. It was an honor, it was a pleasure to have you here. You know what I'm saying? It's been a long time to make it. Of course, you know, y'all want to tap in with us too as well. Midnite Mastermind Media on IG. Let us know what it is. You know what I'm saying? Y'all rocking with this episode. What else y'all want to see on this episode coming up soon? We appreciate the support. And, you know, I'm going to give y'all Jay's final thoughts like I typically do. Whatever you're going through, heal yourself first. You know, don't tie people in the mix of your abyss. Find yourself, heal yourself, and build yourself. Most importantly, be about your wealth. You know what I'm saying? Go out there, travel the world, make connections, and live it up. I want to give a special shout out to Trader Truth. Make sure y'all tap in with Bump Box in Houston at the Galleria Mall. One time for Starlito. Most importantly, shout out to my Harlem family, my Ohio family. But as always, be cool like you be cool. This is the Midnite Drive.